Anxiety is kind of a tricky subject to cover, because I think everybody deals with it in a different way, whether that be just from school and life and work to mental disorders where you just can't get out of bed because of it. I think the best way I've heard anxiety described was by one of my teachers from high school, actually. He described it as worrying that you'd forgotten your keys while driving your car. And I really like that example of anxiety and how it works in people's lives. It can be used to motivate, but it can also be used to demotivate as well. You can get no motivation out of anxiety, or you can get all of your motivation out of anxiety. I was able to get my friends and people from the organization that I'm in on campus to talk about how they've struggled with anxiety. So here are their stories.
I have struggled with anxiety for about 6 years, coupled with depression. The two together have been extremely detrimental to the way that I view myself and the way that I view other people. I have a lot of trust issues that go with that, and I remember I tried opening up to a few people about it, and they said, "But you're extremely outgoing and you're extremely extroverted, how can you have anxiety?"
Some days are easier than others, as most people have in day-to-day life, with or without anxiety. Some days I feel completely fine and like I'll never struggle with anxiety again or having anxious thoughts. And then the next day I can be kind of panicky and freaking out. There's days where I don't want to leave my house and I would rather just stay inside and just withdraw from people. But as an extrovert, it's extremely important for me to be around people the majority of the time. And so when I'm withdrawing, I'm not only feeding into my anxious behavior, but I'm also feeding into my depression by not being around people. There's certain nights where I'll lay awake and I can't fall asleep because I feel extremely panicky. And my mind is just, I feel like it's racing a million miles an hour. And oftentimes I'm freaking out about something I have no idea why I'm freaking out.
I have experienced success multiple times. It is a constant battle that I may have to be fighting with my entire life. And since becoming a Christian in college, that kind of gave me, it definitely gave me hope. I know that after coming into a relationship with Jesus, that he has given me just a peace, and I know that he is bigger than my anxiety and his word is truer than anything that I'm feeling or experiencing.
I've experienced it probably most, if not all, of my life. Definitely started when my parents got a divorce, which I was six, so 15 years ago. Pretty much just since then. Sometimes every day, sometimes I won't for like a month, which is awesome. I love those months. I guess it depends on what I'm anxious about. Like if it's something that's rational, that you're like, okay, you would be anxious about that, then like usually I just kind of like let myself feel anxious, I guess, because it's, I don't know, I think sometimes anxiety can be a good thing, just because it doesn't let you get careless, but it's when I have, like, that irrational anxiety that, like, causes me to shut down, I get really sick, it causes a lot of, like, physical illness with me, and I essentially just, like, can't do anything, like, I just, not a normal functioning human being when I'm like having anxiety attacks. So yeah. So I was diagnosed with a anxiety disorder this like over December, maybe January. And so they put me on medication because at that point like I couldn't even get myself to a place where I would be able to handle it or learn how to deal with it or things like that. So that like the medication definitely helped me getting on like a level playing field, I guess, Then therapy really helped because I found out that I catastrophized. So one thing, like I'll be worried about something and then it just snowballs and gets way bigger into something that's just irrational and it's honestly most of the time really stupid.
I've had anxiety and depression for as long as I can remember. Having anxiety as a kid is rough because in my situation, it's all I've ever known. Even as an adult, I still don't understand it, what it is, how I got it, and most importantly, what life was like without anxiety. All I know is anxiety and how it affects my life. For the longest time, my depression and anxiety worked together against me and also fought one another for years. Although a month ago for spring break, I went to Panama City Beach with a bunch of friends with an on-campus ministry here at ETSU called Crew. On that retreat, I gave my depression to the Lord, and even though my anxiety didn't disappear with my depression, it has gotten better and I will keep fighting every day, where one day I will actually understand what it's like to not have any mental disorders.